Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to take a look at how to spawn physics objects inside Blueprint Script. So first thing we're going to need is a physics object to spawn. So we have the Blueprint third person project up here, but you could use any project you would like. And I did include starter content so that we have some meshes to play with. And first thing we're going to do is go to the content browser and click add new. So go ahead and click add new, and then up here go ahead and select the Blueprint class button. So let's go ahead and select that. And the pick parent class, we're going to create an actor. So go ahead and select actor. And just going to call this physics object. Okay, we're going to double click on that to open it up. And here we're going to specify the object that we want to spawn. We're currently looking at the viewport inside the Blueprint editor here. The construction script and the event graph are graphs we can use to script the functionality behind our blueprints. We're not going to worry about those for this particular object. All we're going to do is create something that we can spawn. So we're going to go to the components pane up here and click the add component button. And we're going to add a static mesh. So we're going to scroll down to find static mesh and select it. And this is just going to be called object. That's fine. And over in the details panel, under static mesh, we have the option to choose what static mesh it is we want to assign to this component. So we're going to click the drop down here. And because I have starter content enabled, I have a bunch of meshes to play with. I'm just going to choose one. We're going to choose a table. Yes, we have a table. It's a SM round table. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And there's a table. That's the object that we're going to spawn. And we're also going to make sure that we choose to simulate physics on our object. And with that, we're going to compile and save. So now we have a physics object. If I hit simulate here, you should see that it starts to fall. There's no floor, so it's just going to continue to fall off into space down there. So let's not do that. With that, yeah, compile and save and close this blueprint. So to actually spawn our blueprint here, we're actually going to go into the level blueprint. So to do that, let's go to the blueprints button up here on the toolbar. Go ahead and click that. And you'll see open level blueprint. So let's go ahead and open our level blueprint. And here is a graph, the event graph, just like our other blueprint, where we can provide the functionality for our blueprints. And I'm going to right click and add a new node. And let's add an input. Let's search for input. And when I type in input, if I scroll down, scroll up, there it is. Here we go. We have mouse events. We have key events. That we can input. Let's go ahead and find, actually I probably should have just typed in F. Yeah, there we go, that was easier. So whenever I press F, let's go ahead and select that. Whenever I press F, execute whatever is connected to this wire, which is gonna be to spawn our blueprint that we just created a moment ago. So let's right click and choose spawn actor from class. There it is, spawn actor from class. And connect the pressed just by left clicking and dragging this node or this wire, this executable to create a wire between the two. And for the class, let's find our physics object. Is that what we called it? Did we call it physics object? Yeah, we did. So we're going to select physics object. Probably should have gave it a better name than physics object, but this will do. So we're going to spawn our physics object, and it's asking for a spawn transform, the transform or position in world space where to spawn this object. Now to find that, we're going to do a little bit of a cheat. Let's hop back to our level really quickly, just going by this tab here. In the modes panel, we can search for things. Let's go ahead and search for a target point. And this is really useful for defining spawn locations. So let's go ahead and drag, left click and drag and drop one into our level here. And I'm just going to drag it up and place it up in the sky like so, something like that. So now that we have a target point in our level, I'm going to hop back to the level blueprint here. And I'm going to minimize it really quickly. Well, not the whole thing. Just maybe drag it off. There we go. There's a couple things, a couple ways you can do this. Probably the most common is to just right click and create a reference to our target point. Because we have it still selected on our level here. So I could right click and say create reference to our target point. Another way we could do it is inside our world outliner here, we have it selected. We could just left click and drag and drop it inside our level blueprint, like so. So now that we have a reference to this target point in our level, we can say, let's maximize this again so you can see what's going on. We can drag off this and say get actor transform or the transform of this target point. And use that as a location to spawn our physics object. So go ahead and connect that like that, like so. Hit compile, and let's undock this and move it over. And let's play in our level here. Now, when I press F, it should spawn our table. And there you go. It's a physics object. And I can spawn a whole bunch of them on top of each other, like so. Oh, look at that. There we go. So there you go. That's how you can spawn a physics object. One quick handy thing that we can show you really quickly. Let's go ahead and hit escape, hop back to our level blueprint. Say we wanted to have a bunch of different spawn points in here. We always don't want to spawn it at this same location. What we can do is hold Alt and drag a copy out of our target point, like so. I'm holding Alt and the left mouse button to drag out a copy of our target point here. And let's select it again and hold Alt and drag out another copy this way. And let's hold Control and select each of our target points here. Then hold Alt and drag out copies of all of those. Now we have 6 potential locations where our table could spawn. Now let's hop back over to our level blueprint here. And let's move our F key over just a little bit to the left here, because we're going to do something nifty in here. What we're going to do is right click in the graph, and we're going to search for Get All Actors of Class. Get All Actors of Class. And we're going to connect the pressed to the end of our Get All Actor from Class node here. You can see it's acting for a class, asking for a class. So let's go ahead and click the drop down here and let's search for target point, because that's what we want to find. And once it has all of these, what we want to do is drag off the out actors, which is all the actors that it gets. What we're going to do is get one of those. So we're going to search for get. And let's move these down just a little bit. I just left clicked and dragged to highlight those and then just dragged them down. We're going to get one of those, and it's asking for an index. It's asking for which one of those to get. So we're going to drag off of this, left click and drag, and we're going to search for random. So we're going to search for a random integer in range. So it gives us a min and a max. The min we know is 0, because in programmer speak, an array, which is what this is, this little checkerboard box here, programmer speak, an array starts at index 0 instead of 1. It's a 0-based system. So we know that min is 0, but the max, we don't know how many it is. Well, actually, we do. We could just say 6 because we play 6, but we're going to do something even fancier. We're going to drag off of this again, and we're going to say length. Get the length of our array. And that's going to give us an integer, and that's going to allow us to plug it in like so. And then for this, we can kill our target point that we were using before, our single target point. We can select it and hit delete. We can then connect our out to our in on our getActorTransform and make sure that our executable is connected here, like so. And that looks good. Let's hit compile, and let's play in the editor. And now each time we press F, we are going to spawn our table at a different location in our level. It is raining tables on us. So there you go. You've learned how to spawn a physics object. And not only that, learn how to spawn it at a random location in your level that you specify as spawn points. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching.